The Sims is a game about life. You create and control these little people and the houses they live in, and then create a life for them to live out. I've been lucky enough to work at The Sims Studio for almost 12 years now. I started back on The Sims Unleashed, the original Pets game. The Sims started out as an architecture game about building houses, and The Sims themselves existed to give feedback about those houses. We quickly realized The Sims were way more interesting and that we really wanted to play out their stories. I think The Sims appeals to so many different people because it really is a blank canvas for you to start telling whatever story you can imagine. If you want to be a builder, or if you want to just make little people that you know, if you want to just tell a story about their lives, it really can be anything you want it to be. I think the reason The Sims has lasted for nearly 15 years now is it's such a personal game. Everyone connects to it in a different way. Whether you're telling a story about your own life, or trying to play out a situation that maybe could have been, or trying something crazy, it means something different to everyone, which is really a connection that you don't get with a lot of other games. The Sims community is an amazingly passionate and active community. We have millions of players across more than 60 different countries that are constantly creating things in The Sims and sharing their stories with us. One thing that's really interesting about our Sims players is no matter where they come from, they've formed this extremely tight-knit community that is constantly sharing and collaborating and creating these amazing things in the game. It could be a family, it could be a house, it could be a movie that they've made together, and we're constantly impressed by what they've been able to do with The Sims. I'll have my Sim make a nice cup of coffee and then get in the bath and just fall asleep. He just gets all calm and goes, ah.
The new thing about The Sims 4 is The Sims themselves, because they have these great big personalities and they're completely driven by emotion. And that fundamentally changes the way you play the game. Sims have always been expressive. But in The Sims 4, players can actually control the emotions of their Sim. And this unlocks new possibilities and choices for the players. So for example, if your Sim is angry, you might think that that's a bad thing. But in reality, it unlocks new choices for your Sim and new actions that your Sim can take. So an angry Sim could go for a rage run on the treadmill or do some angry push-ups and actually level up faster in the fitness skill because of that emotional state. The Sims is about life, and playing with life never gets old. I make my Sims take pregnancy tests on the toilet, and sometimes they don't need it.
Simlish is the language of The Sims. It's kind of a gibberish language of emotion. All the vocalizations, all the talking that they do is about communicating to the player what's going on. And they cry, they laugh, they giggle, they tell jokes, but it doesn't translate. There are probably 100 words that have translations, nubu, baby, that type of thing. And then we have some new words that we're actually bringing from various Sims titles in the past, which are kind of concepts. So we talk about fretiche, which is food, but it could be I'm cooking food, I'm hungry, do you want to go out to dinner? It could be any food topic. But those are just added in there so that you keep consistently knowing kind of what your Sims are looking for. The Sims has been around 15 years. I think the reason is that everybody just wants to tell a story. They want to have a relationship with characters and a world that's all their own, and they share that with their friends, and their friends share their stories, and you talk about it, and then you go back and you create new stories because now you find out your friends have done something you haven't done, and it's an exciting way to be. I think telling stories is what we're all about as human beings, and that The Sims gives you that power. I really like to take 3 or 4 random Sims, throw them on music instruments that they have various skills on, you know, piano, violin, guitar, one badly played, one really well played, one somewhere in the middle, and you get a modern music concert.